My name is Patrick Highsmith, and I'm the new CEO of Timberline. We have had a lot of news lately, and I'll be telling you about that. Being a geologist, I will make some forward-looking statements, so please apprise yourself of the cautionary language here and on our website. Timberline's exploring in Nevada, and I have to say that's a highlight of the opportunity with Timberline. We're focused there on a certain type of sediment-hosted gold deposits called Carlin type, yielded millions of ounces and some very profitable mines in that part of the world. Our flagship asset is the Eureka Project. This is a district-scale play on a prolific and historic trend. We're going to take you through a little bit of that trend and focus on our 60-square-kilometer Eureka Project, where more than $20 million has been spent, and we're building on that knowledge to focus on higher grade resources going forward. So our target is higher grade Carlin type deposits, and we're beginning with our 2020 drill program around our existing resource and pushing out into the areas of potential high grade with what we learned from that work. We're bringing some new technology and a new team, as Chin noted, and also a lot more core drilling than has previously been seen in the district. As I mentioned, there is a resource there. We have about 500,000 ounces of gold at surface, averaging about 0.66 grams per ton in a measured and indicated category. But we believe that's just the start. It comes to surface, there's high grade mineralization at surface, and there's also oxide mineralization there. As Chin said, we're actively drilling. About 80% of the program is complete. And let's just say we're filling up the lab with samples. Results are starting to come soon. So let's have a look at Nevada for those of you who aren't as familiar with it. It's a world-class true mining jurisdiction. It has the culture. It has three generations now of modern gold mining there and about 23 major gold mines producing more than 5 million ounces annually. There's also growing copper and lithium production there. So the legal, the infrastructure, the workforce, the things we need to get work done are present in Nevada. And of course, Fraser Institute and others reliably rate Nevada highly as a destination for investment. So if we look at Nevada, the major gold trends are shown here, the Carlin trend in Northeast Nevada, the Battle Mountain Eureka trend more in Central Nevada, and that's where we're working. Timberline's actually a pure play on gold. We have three major projects. Our flagship we're going to talk about today is Eureka, here more at the south end of the trend. But at the northern end of that trend at Battle Mountain, we have another major project called Paiute that we're the operator in a joint venture with Nevada Gold Mines, Barrick and Newmont there. We also have a large property here at Seven Troughs, a district scale property that's more epithermal gold and silver veins, some bonanza grade there historically. And we're sort of planning for what the program might look like there next year. But let's talk about Eureka. We've zoomed in here at the south end of the Battle Mountain Eureka trend. Note the scale bar, about 4 kilometers. This is a large property position. Just north of us, about 8 kilometers, was Barrick's and Homestake's historic Ruby Hill mine. In total, 4 to 5 million ounces of resources and past production there at Ruby Hill. Looking north, of course, McEwen Mining operates at the Gold Bar mine. Further north, of course, at the Cortez Pipeline District, we have the Barrick Newmont or Nevada Gold Mines joint venture. And of course, the important Gold Rush underground discovery there that's being developed. So this is a trend with many multi-million ounce deposits and more than 30 million ounces of remaining reserves and resources. So it's a great place to be in the gold business. So what we have at Eureka is somewhat unique. And that's because we're a junior company with a district scale land position, but we have oxide resources at surface, and we have high grade mineralization. That's much greater than 3 grams per ton at surface. So when we look at the project as a whole though, you can see there are actually three trends on the property. The map you're looking at is gold in rocks and soils, and warm colors would represent high gold at surface. So first, the lookout target that we'll be speaking in some detail about sits here where our historic resource is. Then we've got the Oswego trend in the middle, and the Windfall trend on the east. Windfall was the site of a historic mine as well, produced over 100,000 ounces of gold there. In fact, it may have been the first heap leach mine in Nevada or in the US. We're gonna focus at Lookout, however, on the west side of the property. Each of these trends, more than 4 kilometers of drill indicated gold at surface, a lot of work to do to assess this big district. We're starting at Lookout, where 18,000 ounces of gold were produced, but with an average grade of 4.1 grams, quite high grade for open pit mining. The resources themselves, we delineated about 700,000 ounces of gold, 500,000 of that in the measured and indicated category, with an average grade of 0.66 grams. Fair chunk of that is oxide, but we're most interested in the high grade. We have up to 8 grams or a bit more sticking out of the ground in the pit areas, and understanding that high grade is the key to what comes next. And this is where we've been drilling as we test the around the resource area and stepping out from it. So we've zoomed in to the Eureka resource area here, outlined in red, and this is the historic open pit. Now we'll talk about the drill holes in a minute, but let me talk about a couple of things geologically. The breakthrough here was in 2005 to 2007, and a company called Staccato Gold, which we acquired, was the first to bring core drilling to this part of the district. And in that, they produced the drill core produced a lot better geologic record, so we could understand better the key elements of Carlin mineralization, silicification, decalcification, and also iron-rich dolomite. But most important is the word breccia. Quite frankly, breccia is the key. And when we drilled the core, we could see that this rock had been shattered in a number of places. And when it's shattered, it forms this fragmented rock we call a breccia that creates porosity and permeability for the fluids to move through. And it's often associated with higher grades. So when you look at the drilling here, you can see these holes in red. Well, they contain more than 8 grams per ton assays in those drill holes. The light green holes contain more than 3.5 grams per ton. So there was high grade in a lot of these holes. So we came back in this year and delineated the drilling program around the existing resource and stepping out outside of the resource to the east and to the north. These green holes have been completed that you see here. Those are reverse circulation drilling, good for getting samples where we sort of understand the geology. But now we've stepped outside the resource with core holes shown in blue circles here that are stepping out quite a bit to the east. The thing about Carlin type geology, you're looking for shale and limestone. You can see from this map, we have shale here, limestone in blue. Those rocks are dipping out to the east and getting flat out to the east, where we drilled them a couple of years ago into an area we call the water well or the Orpiment discovery zone. Over 5 grams per ton down there over significant thicknesses. So this is where we've come in and around that discovery zone with new drilling, both core and RC. And this is kind of what it looks like. Here's a photo of the core, and you see some gray and dark colored rocks. These are siltstones or shales usually with carbon in there, carbonaceous material giving it the dark color. But the bright yellow stuff is what we like. That's called orpiment, and that's arsenic sulfides. And it often goes with quite high grade gold in Carlin type deposits. So now that we understood the key elements of the controls on this mineralization, the higher grade, we bring in a new team. We infuse that team with new technology and new financing this year with some new investors. And we've been drilling actively on this 4,500 meter program. But it isn't just one pod of mineralization here. There's a lot of potential at Lookout, and we expect to be drilling that out over the next quite a little while here. But what I want to show you is property scale to capability here. We have now surveyed the whole property with gravity data, which shows us offsets in the different rock types. The linears you see in this complicated map are major faults. Those faults bring fluids to the surface. Here we see the windfall trend lined up on one of those faults. Here we see the lookout trend lined up on one of these faults. But notice this area here. The gravity seems to be indicating alteration. This is really exciting because you see gold occurrences around this area of alteration shown in green here. And this again reveals more targets for us to apply new forms of geophysics. We're going to be bringing in controlled source audio magnetotellurics to look at the electrical properties of the rock. And an IP survey right now is underway to show us where the rock might be conductive at depth. Those things indicate the presence of sulfides, which often go with gold. So that work will continue right till the end of the year. And the drill is still turning on the core holes right now. But what we see is a target-rich environment. Frankly, we'll be working in the core of the lookout zone, developing targets there to the south. And next year, we'll be paying more attention to the windfall zone as well. So it's a district, and there will be multiple drill programs in the future here. So at Timberline, the team's a big part of the story. And with over 250 years experience on this team, it would take me about that long to tell you about it. So I'll just say that, as Chin mentioned, Dr. Quentin Hinton's team, a noted economic geologist with a lot of discoveries under his belt, Dave Mathewson, one of the most prolific ore finders in Nevada, is on the board and has been directing the technical program, helping with that. Dave probably found as many ounces for Newmont as any of their team. So with those guys on board, and then also we have folks like Bill Matlack and myself, still technically trained, but a little bit more capital markets focus. And we've been around for some transactions and some financings in our career as well. We have about 112 million shares outstanding, and we've about 28% of that is held at the board level. So we've certainly got a lot of skin in the game at the board and management level in the company. In a financing earlier this year, we brought in Crescat Capital and Condire Resource to be a couple of sizable institutional investors. That was an infusion of new capital and a lot of enthusiasm with that. Quinton came on board and I came on board soon after that. And we're now sitting with a market capitalization of around 30 million and a share price of 27 to 28 cents recently. So winding up talking about the highlights, you can't say enough about working in Nevada. It's a world-class jurisdiction, and it's a great place to work with a lot of quality people and infrastructure. We're in a district scale asset on a major gold trend, and that's a great place to be when you're in the gold business. We do begin with a core of M&I resources, the right to the surface that gives us a great place to start and to build up our knowledge base. And the high grade within that is pretty important. Here you see a table, for instance. These are just some selected results that are more than 6 grams over significant thicknesses, but all shallower than 150 meters. What happened here, as you've heard from some of the other junior companies today, is that historically the drilling was all very, very shallow, 100 meters or less, and focused on only oxide mineralization. Here in Nevada, we can mine high grade to considerable depths, and the major companies are doing just that. So when we see intercepts like 20 meters of can't even see my screen anymore, 20 meters of 8 grams or something like that. Yeah, 20 meters of 11 grams, sorry, 23 meters of 10 grams, 17 meters of 12 grams. This is high grade mineralization pretty near the surface. So we've got a lot of work to do to fill that in and grow this resource. We brought an experienced team of ore finders to the table. And we've got a strong budget that supported this drilling program and a lot of work to do ahead as the news comes out. Follow us this winter as the drill results come in, geophysics comes out, and we'll be setting up for a great year in 2021. Important to remember, at Timberline, we have over 200 permitted drill sites on this project. So when we find something, we're going to be able to put more holes in it. Thank you very much for your time and look forward to questions later.